Welcome to the Windows Club. If Microsoft Office applications will open on your computer only when you use the option to run it as an administrator, then please watch this video. I will discuss the causes and the resolutions. First of all, let us assume that we have Outlook here, which is a Microsoft Office application. If I double click on it, it won't open. But if I right click on it and select run as administrator, it will open. In this case, the first solution will be to remove Microsoft Office from sleep feature from third-party optimizers. As an example, I have CCleaner here. I'll go to the Performance Optimizer tab on the list on the left-hand side. If corresponding to Microsoft 365, the sleep feature is on, then we have to switch it off. The second solution is to repair Microsoft Office. Right-click on the Start button and select Settings from the menu. In the Settings menu, go to the Apps tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, select Installed Apps. Now wait for the list to load. Now scroll down to Microsoft 365. After you scroll down to Microsoft 365, click on the three dots associated with it and select Modify. In the corresponding menu, select Online Repair and then click on Repair. Click on Repair once again. It will start repairing your Microsoft Office client. The third solution will be to check for the permission settings. Let us assume we need to check them for Microsoft Outlook. Right click on this application and select Show More Options. Now click on Properties, go to the Security tab, click on Administrators, click on Edit, click on Administrators once again and make sure that you give it full control. Click on Apply and then on OK. To save the settings, finally click on OK to save the primary settings. The last solution, if everything else fails, is to create a new local computer or a new other user account. Right click on the Start button and select Settings from the menu. Go to the Accounts tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, scroll down to Other Users and click on it. Click on Add Account. Wait for the list to load, it will need a few minutes. After that, click on I don't have this person sign in information. It will ask you to create an account and you can create a new account here. Let us say I can create my own different ID and so on. But it should be @hotmail.com or @outlook.com. Isn't this easy and interesting? If you have any doubts, please go to the original article on the Windows Club. Scroll down to the comment section and write your query. We will surely answer to it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day.